Joining me from his electorate of Maranoa in Queensland is the Nationals leader, David Littleproud. David Littleproud, thanks so much for your time.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Tanya Plibersek, she says your nuclear power plants are going to cost $387 billion. What do you say to that?
Well, that'd be a fraction of what their plan by 2030 of 82% renewables would cost. It's $1.5 trillion, and that's Net Zero Australia who's articulated those numbers, and then $7 to $9 trillion between 2060. And so this is why we're saying we want to leave a legacy that just doesn't last for 15 to 20 years, which is what a turbine or a solar panel might last, or even a battery. We want something that'll last 80 to 100 years, something that'll build baseload power into our grid, that'll underpin manufacturing, that'll keep hospital lights on, something that renewables and batteries can't do. This is a threshold question Australians need to understand.
All right.
If you don't have baseload power, you can't keep subsidising manufacturing to keep it in this country. And you only have to look at your lived experience. Anthony Albanese spent $6.5 billion in trying to make an election promise of a $275 reduction because he's got this all renewables approach.
They say their poles and wires, the renewables rollout, whatever, is $121 billion, not a trillion, like the opposition's been saying. What do you say to that?
Well, I think what you need to look at is what Net Zero Australia are talking about, because what you need to do is plug them in with 28,000 kilometres of transmission lines and then rely on a whole lot of battery technology that at the moment has very limited capacity and would have to spend a lot to actually increase that capacity to build baseload power. And it simply can't be done anywhere around the world. But also, it doesn't take into account what they're going to cost you in your food security, because we're tearing up prime agricultural land that takes away food supply, that lifts up food prices.
Right.
And so this is where this folly of what this government is going down an ideological view doesn't match the reality. When Net Zero Australia are telling us, who are eminently qualified, telling us $1.5 trillion, I think that says a fair bit about Labor's plan. And you can feel that in your energy bills now.
You didn't even flinch, though, when I said $387 billion for your nuclear power plants. Is that in the ballpark?
Well, we'll be very upfront and clear about the costings and about the scale and capacity of what nuclear energy will firm up and transition some of our coal-fired power stations across with gas. And you're going to need a lot of gas, as they will with an all-renewables approach. But there will be renewables in that mix as well. So we'll be very upfront and honest. There is an upfront capital cost. Peter Dutton and I have been very clear about that. There is an upfront cost, but you get to amortise that over 80 to 100 years. Not have some multinational from overseas slip in, take a 15 to 20 year dividend out of the Australian people, run back to wherever they're from. This is something the Australian people will own. And so there's a big difference about the upfront costs and the dividends that it'll pay back over the life of the assets, not a 20-year asset, but a 100-year asset.
Yeah, that's right. Well, the CSIRO found its recent Gen Cost report, it would cost about $8.6 billion to construct a reactor, and the first reactor would be more expensive. Do you accept that calculation?
Look, that part of the Gen costs, we've been more than upfront saying that that is in the ballpark, but we'll be very specific about those costs and those upfront costs. And we're also being upfront about who owns this. Not some carpetbagger from overseas comes in, takes it all and runs back for a 15 to 20 year period. This will be something that lasts for 80 to 100 years. There's a big difference in this. And yes, there always has been an upfront cost, but it's the long-term dividend that's paid back to the Australian people in their ownership and in reliable baseload power.
Have you got calculations then on operating cost, which I assume the $387 billion that Tanya Plibersek is talking about takes into account?
Well, we'll be very clear. Those costings will be upfront and honest. And there's international experience where you've got established nuclear power plants up and running, where you can benchmark and look at the moment. So those costings will be delivered. We wanted to show respect to those communities that we announced. We wanted to take... Well before the election. And this is where this is a significant change in policy that the Nationals and Liberals are bringing. And we want to be take the Australian people on that journey with us. We want to be honest about that. And I think it was firstly starting that 2.5 year consultation process with those communities in making sure they understood. And then the next phase will be delivery of those costings and what our energy mix will look like, not putting all our energy eggs in one basket.